Hey people, so I've been wanting to get back into doing stuff with electronics, and I've also been wanting to get into crypto a little bit, so I've made this. This is my little mining rack for raspberries. I've got three Raspberry Pi trees, four Raspberry Pi trees on here, each with their own little buck converter. And a little boost converter for the fan to take the 5 volts that the raspberries require and boost it up to about 10 to keep it at a good speed. And it's all fed via an old laptop power brick. I think it's 20 volts, 4.5 amps. The whole thing consumes 24.5 watts as it is, and as for cooling, I had to the bare chip, the bare die was a bit underwhelming, and I didn't have any what are they called, heat spreaders. So I made some by cutting a larger heat spreader down into pieces with a Dremel. I've ordered some copper ones that are actually made for the raspberries, but this will do until now. They keep, along with the fan, they keep them at about 55 degrees, which is 5 or 6 degrees below throttling. And the whole thing is 3D printed. It's made up of little segments for each raspberry, and the bottom plate is a two-piece, mostly to make the whole printing process a bit easier. So this one goes into its little slot down there, and 3 points for the fans, for the fan. And the currency I'm mining is Varium Reserve, because it's one of the few CPU mineable only cryptos I can find, and I wanted to use that for the raspberries because they don't really have any graphics. And I think my numbers are a bit muddy now because I got other stuff mining as well. I got a bit too carried away, and I believe these were mining 0.06 Varium per day, these four on their own, and that should be about $0.75. And so they're making profit. Now this little USB cable here is because I said I got carried away, and one of the things I set up for mining was my old Samsung Galaxy S5. There we go. Running at about 250 hash per minute. Now, I had to cut the cable open because if you just plug 5 volts into the port, it will only charge at about half an amp, and that is not enough to well, charge it while it's mining. It'll use more power than it is getting. So by shorting those, it'll go full ham, so it will be running 1.9 amps on the charger, which it should be doing now because I've been running it without. So we went from 24.5 to 32, so 8 watts more power, and it'll go down to about 30, so 6 watts in usage when it's done charging. But each raspberry mines, I know these numbers may not mean a lot to you, but they mine at about 185 hash per minute. This one is running at, as I said, at about 220 to 250, depending on its mood. I also made a script for my PC, my workstation slash gaming computer, where I use two of my four cores for mining. So basically, when I boot up to start the script, it starts mining on the last two cores, and I find this to be very beneficial because my computer's on anyway, I'm using it, so the CPU is running at full power, and I don't really notice any performance loss, even though it's running two cores at 100%, because a bunch of the game I play don't really use all that much CPU, and those who do, in Windows will have a higher priority than the miner, so the miner will just throttle down. It's a win-win. It's basically free mining. And those two cores alone run at 1200 hash per minute, so basically doubling everything and then some. But I think that's about all I have about this little project. It took a bit to draw, a bit to print. Very frustrating print, getting everything to fit together. But yeah, worked out in the end. So thank you for watching, and see ya.